I live in the East Village in Manhattan, so I take the subway multiple times a day. In this instance, I was coming from school. I got out of class around 2:15, and I took the J Street. I was at J Street Metro Tech. Took the Uptown F train. At Second Avenue, a man came on, stumbled on. He appeared to be on drugs. The doors closed, and he ripped his jacket off and threw it at the people sitting down to my left. I was listening to music at the time, and he was yelling, so I took my headphones out to hear what he was yelling. And the three main threats that he repeated over and over was, I'm going to kill you, I'm prepared to go to jail for life, and I'm willing to die. You know, this was a scary situation, and Mr. Yearly came on. He was threatening. I'm 6'2", and he was taller than me. So it was, and there's a common misconception that Marines don't get scared. We're actually taught one of our core values is courage, and courage is not the absence of fear, but how you handle fear. And, you know, I was scared for myself, but I looked around, I saw women and children. He was yelling in their faces, saying these threats. I couldn't just sit still. Some people say that I was holding on to Mr. Ely for 15 minutes. This is not true. I mean, between stops is only a couple minutes. So the whole interaction lasted less than 5 minutes. Some people say I was trying to choke him to death, which is also not true. I was trying to restrain him. You can see in the video, there's a clear rise and fall of his chest, indicating that he's breathing. I'm trying to restrain him from him being able to carry out the threats. And then some people say that this was about race, which is absolutely ridiculous. I didn't see a black man threatening passengers. I saw a man threatening passengers, a lot of whom were people of color. The man who helped restrain Mr. Neely was a person of color. And a few days after the incident, I read in the papers that a woman of color came out and called me a hero. What I don't believe that I'm a hero, but she was one of those people that I was trying to protect. We were all scared. Mr. Neely was yelling in these passengers' faces, and they looked terrified. The reason why there was no video at the start of the altercation was because people were too afraid getting away from him. And the videos didn't start until they saw the situation was under control. I knew I had to act, and I acted in a way that would protect the other passengers, protect myself, and protect Mr. Neely. I used this hole to restrain him, and I did this by leaving my hand on top of his head to control his body. You can see in the video there's a clear rise and fall of his chest, indicating that he was still breathing. And I'm calibrating my grip based on the force that he's exerting. And I was trying to keep him on the ground until the police came. I was praying that the police would come and take this situation over. I didn't want to be put in that situation, but I couldn't just sit still and let him carry out these threats.
For those of you that didn't know who this guy is, that was Daniel Penny, the guy that was responsible for choking Jordan Neely to death at a New York subway station about a month ago. See, the only reason why he comes out and speaks out, because I bet you his attorney's allowing it to happen is to hear his side of the story, right? But I'm going to say this. There's multiple witnesses has said Daniel Penny, well, they didn't say his name, but he said, get off of him, get off of him. And he choked this man from behind. Now, he threw his jacket on the ground. He didn't make no threatening gestures or attacking Daniel Penny. You know, he was like, well, he's trying to protect the people. But you got not just yourself, but two additional dudes with you that restraining him. But see, now you see what's going on, ladies and gentlemen, that obviously you see a guy like this is freely to speak his defense, allegedly. And then when you have his father, who was the police lieutenant in the New York State Police Department, also because he's protected by him. You're gonna be making a statement like this. Now, as you may know, a lot of people talk about, oh, it's not about race. It isn't about race. It's not true. I'm protecting the people of color. According to the video, that basically what we just saw, you initially choked this man to death. Within like nearly 15 minutes. And you got not just yourself, but you got three additional dudes with you. In my opinion, they also need to be charged for accessory. But see, ladies and gentlemen, this is what I'm talking about. This guy right here, who now can speak in his defense, saying, well, he was threatening everybody, and he threw a jacket on the ground. But he's not a threat to you. You the one that sneaked this man from behind. He didn't come to you and try to make ready to fight or do threatening gestures. He don't even have a weapon in his hand. And because of the protection you have, your dad is the police lieutenant, a retired police lieutenant of the New York State Police Department. All of a sudden, now since you're free and clear, maybe his lawyers is now want him to speak in his defense of what happened that day. He said, well, he's trying to protect everybody from these threats. What threats did he make, sir? Oh, you talking about, well, he's going to kill himself, blah, 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 blah. But ladies and gentlemen, he didn't come after people on the train. He didn't come after you. You came on behind him. And remember, the New York State passed a law when it comes to banning chokeholds. So basically, he said, it's not true. He allowed him to breathe. Sir, according to the video, he wasn't breathing. His eyes was closed when you keep choking him. So all the stuff you're saying, sir, it doesn't match what the video's saying. And like I said, he is protecting him because his father was a retired police lieutenant in the NY State Police Department. But I digress. And I know people in the comment section say, no, he's attacking everybody and blah, 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 blah. Have y'all ever even seen the damn video? Have y'all seen the video? Dude, he's not even conscious. When he's choking him, he is lights out. He's not even moving muscle. And then we said, well, one of the minorities calling him a hero. And then there's only one witness that came out. That's a Hispanic man saying, oh, he was belligerent. He was threat, blah, blah, blah. But you haven't heard any multiple witnesses coming out in, you know, Jordan Neely's defense saying that, listen, this guy is attacking him. Y'all let me know what you think about this in the comments. I mean, this is just ridiculous. And the only reason why he speaks out now is because his attorneys want him to speak out in his defense, calling him a hero and everything else. And yet the video says it differently. Y'all let me know what you think in the comments. I'll talk to you in the next video. This is Lions Insight off. Deuces.